In this video, we're going to talk about what are called mixture problems, and I have an example for us to consider. Okay, so how many ounces of 20% cacao chocolate and how many ounces of 70% cacao chocolate should be mixed together to obtain 24 ounces of 50% cacao chocolate? Okay, so the basic idea is that you're taking this pretty weak chocolate, right, 20%, and you're mixing it with this really dark chocolate, and you're ending up with 24 ounces of 50%. So the 50% is somewhere in the it's somewhere between 20 and 70%, right? So the question is, how much of each of these should you mix to get 24 ounces of 50% chocolate? Okay, so before we begin on this problem, I want to think of another situation with you just to sort of get the ball rolling. Now, let's say that you had some juice, okay? So I'm going to draw in a bottle of juice here. So this is our container of juice. And let's say that it says on the bottle that it's 20% real juice. Okay, how about real apple juice? That's what our label says. And let's say that you look at the volume, that is, you figure out somewhere on there it tells you how much is in there. And let's say that you have 500 milliliters. Okay, so this is the overall size of the volume of liquid inside this container. Now, what's inside here? Well, it's not all apple juice, right? Only 20% is apple juice. What else is in there? Well, water and sugar and whatever else, right? So the point is that of these 500 milliliters, only a certain number of them are pure apple juice, okay? And if you want to figure out that, you know, if you want to know how many of those milliliters are pure apple juice, how do you do that? Well, the answer is you take the percentage, right? So in this case, you take 0.20 and you multiply it by the amount, which is 500. Okay, and when you multiply these together, what you get is 100. So what does that mean? Well, that means that of these 500 milliliters, 100 of the milliliter, or 100 milliliters are pure apple juice. Okay, so what we basically are talking about is multiplying the percent by the amount to get the amount of pure substance, right? Let's write that down. We're going to refer to the percentage as the rate. So we take the rate and we multiply it by the amount. And when you do that, amount, that leaves you with pure, okay? The amount of pure substance you have, okay? So rate times amount gives pure. Okay, with that in mind, let's go ahead and tackle our mixture problem here. So we're mixing 20% chocolate and 70% chocolate to get 24 ounces of 50% chocolate. Okay, let's go to another page for this. Okay, let's write down what we have. Well, first of all, what are we looking for? We are looking for the amount of 20% chocolate we need to add, right? So let's write that down. X is going to be the, it's going to be the number of ounces, right? So the number of ounces of 20% chocolate and we're also looking for how much 70% chocolate, right? So let's go ahead and write that down. Y is the number of ounces of the 70% chocolate. So the problem is asking us for two things, right? And I'm letting X be the first and Y be the second. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to create a table to organize all the information. And the table is going to look a whole lot like the table we used in the distance rate time problem, okay? So let's create that table now. Okay, so here's our table. And once again, we have three columns, column one, column two, and column three. And we also have two rows, row one and row two. Now, we label the columns very similarly to how we label them with the rate time distance problem. So we're going to call this the rate. So we'll just label that as R. The first column is rate. Now, the second column, we're going to label as amount. And it's going to be the same amount that we had on the previous page. And then the third column is going to be labeled as pure. And you'll see why we're doing this in a second. Now, the two rows are going to be labeled as well, right? So here's row one and here's row two. So the first row, so we label these rows using, or thinking about rather, what we're combining. So what am I combining in this case? Well, I'm combining weak chocolate and strong chocolate, right? So this will be the weak chocolate, and this will be the strong chocolate, right? So these rows you label in terms of what you're adding together. So let's go, now remember, each of these little squares has a meaning. Like for example, this square means the amount of weak chocolate that we're adding. This square means the rate, or in this case, the percentage cacao, of strong chocolate, okay? And what does this mean, for example, this square? Well, this means that this refers to how much pure cacao you're adding when you add this amount together, right? And the reason is because when you multiply, as we saw on the previous page, when you multiply the percentage by the amount, what you get is the pure amount, okay? So that's how it's gonna go. Rate times amount, or percentage times amount, is gonna give the amount of pure substance, okay? In this case, pure cacao. So let's see how this plays out. Now, you know that I like to enter the easy information first. So on this problem, well, what am I given? Well, the weak chocolate, I know its rate. The rate is 20%, right? So I'm gonna put that in here, 0.20. And I also know the rate of the strong chocolate. That's 0.70, okay? Now, that is the end of the easy information. And you might be thinking, well, what about the 24 ounces? I can't put the 24 ounces in anywhere because 24 ounces refers to the total, right? And this is not the total. This is the amount of weak chocolate. That's clearly not 24 ounces, right? These two together have to add up to be 24, but neither one of them individually is 24. Okay, now we're letting, what is X? X is the number of ounces of 20% chocolate. That's the amount, right? That's the amount of the weak chocolate. We're calling that X. So that's what amount refers to, right? It's how much you're adding of that substance. And likewise, how much strong chocolate are we adding? Well, that's what Y represents, right? Y is the number of ounces that we're adding of the 70% chocolate. So this is gonna be Y, okay? And now we're gonna make use of the logic on the previous page. That is, anytime you know the amount, you can multiply it by the rate to get the amount of pure substance in that quantity, okay? I don't know how much weak chocolate I'm adding, but I do know that if I multiply it by 20%, that'll tell me how many ounces of these X ounces are pure cacao, okay? So just like the previous page, how we had, what was it? It was with our apple juice, right? It was 20% times 500 milliliters, 20% times 500, right? 70% times Y. So that's how you get the pure amount. So in this case, it's gonna be 0.20 times X, okay? That's how, this represents how much cacao is in that number of ounces. And if you wanna know how much cacao is in this number of ounces, well, you multiply this number of ounces by 0.70. So 0.70 multiplied by Y, okay? Okay, now, we know that anytime we have two unknowns, right? Unknown number one and unknown number two, you need two equations. Now, the first equation is fairly obvious, right? Because what has to be true about these when added together? Well, when you add up the number of ounces of weak chocolate to the number of ounces of strong chocolate, we have to get 24 ounces. That's what's required, right? We have to get 24 ounces in total. So the first equation says just that, that X plus Y is equal to 24, okay? And you don't need to write ounces. We're aware that it's in ounces. Okay, now the second equation is gonna make use of the pure substance. Remember, this is number of ounces of cacao. So if you add up the number of ounces of cacao from the weak chocolate to the number of ounces of cacao from the pure chocolate, or from the strong chocolate, right? If I add up these two amounts of cacao, let's go ahead and write that down, 0.20x plus 0.70y, right? I'm adding the amounts of cacao. What am I going to get? Well, clearly, I'm going to get the amount of cacao in the final amount of chocolate. Well, in the final amount of chocolate, there are 24 ounces, right? And that chocolate is 50% cacao. So if you want to know how much cacao is in the 24 ounces, you multiply that by 0.50. So this represents the total cacao. And where'd that cacao come from? Well, some of it came from this, and some of it came from that. So when you add those together, right, add right here, when you add them together, you get the total cacao, which is 0.50 multiplied by 24. Okay? So this is the system we have to solve. We have two equations. So the first thing we're going to do is multiply these two together, 0.5 times 24. Okay, let's do this on another piece of paper. Okay, so here's my system, right? So let's first multiply these two together. So we get x plus y. The top equation remains the same, equals 24. And that bottom equation is, let's see, 0.20x plus 0.70y. And when you multiply 0.5, which is the same as 1/2, times 24, you're going to get 12. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to clear decimals in this bottom equation. Now, I want this decimal to move, well, you could say two places, right? 1, 2. Now, there's really no need to move two places because, look, once you move one place, this becomes 2.0, which is just 2. So, it's okay if this just moves one place, right? Because the decimal will be gone. So, I'll have 2, and if this moves once as well. Now, moving once, to get a decimal to move once, you simply multiply by 10, okay? So, I'm going to multiply both sides of this bottom equation by 10. And what do I get? Well, the top equation remains the same. So it's x plus y equals 24 still. And the bottom equation is going to become, let's see, 2x plus, well, it's going to be 10 times 0.7, right? It's 7y. And the right-hand side is going to be 120. Okay, so now to solve this system, now I'm going to multiply the top equation, both sides, by negative 2. And because I want negative 2x and positive 2x, right, I want to eliminate the x. So both sides of the top equation now gets multiplied by 2. Make that negative 2, right? So both sides by negative 2. So it's going to be negative 2x minus 2y equals, well, it's going to be negative 48 there. And the bottom equation remains the same. So 2x plus 7y equals 120. Okay, now when I add these together, I get, let's see, it's going to be 5y equals, well, 120 take away 48, which is going to be, 72? 52? Yeah, 72. So now we're going to divide both sides by 5. And what do we get? Well, we get y is equal to 72 over 5. Now, remember, y represents the number of ounces of 70% cacao. So nobody says, oh, add 72 over 5 ounces, right? Let's convert this to a mixed number. And we do that by taking 5 and dividing it into 72. So 5 goes into 7 once. And then 5 goes into 22, it's going to be 4 times. Okay, and we get our answer for y, this is the same as 14 and 2/5. So what we have so far is that we need 14 and 2/5 ounces of the 70% chocolate. So 70% chocolate. Now you also have to add in the weaker chocolate, right? How many ounces of the 20% chocolate do you need? Now remember, the number of ounces have to add together to be 24. So I can't have 10, for example, because if I had 10 ounces of 20% chocolate, that would bring me to 24 and 2/5, too much. So what I have is actually I have 9 3/5 ounces. And the way I thought about that was I said, oh, 14 plus 9 gives me 23, and then 2/5 plus 3/5 gives me 5/5, which is 1 more ounce. So 23 plus the 1 here gave me a total of 24 ounces, okay, of chocolate. Okay, so that's how we solve mixture problems. We have to create two equations, and this equation right here is really the tricky one, right? So focus your attention, but remember it's always rate times amount gives you the pure substance. Each of these is rate times amount, and rate times amount. Okay? So for this problem, this was our answer. Okay, and that's how you solve mixture problems.